Alright guys, welcome back to KITESURFFITNESS, Jan here, and in this video I'm diving with you into part 2 of our Don't Join the Knee Club and how to make your landings better and safer from your jumps. Ready? Here we go! Now, doing jumps in kitesurfing and just flying right away is every kitesurfer's dream, right?
You glide over the water, the wind is perfect and you feel the power of your kite. You're ready to send it to take off and fly high into the air to the stars. You feel the adrenaline kick and pure joy of flying. This is your moment of happiness. Now, you sink back towards the water, preparing for the landing, and boom! You bang like a bomb on the water.
This is the moment in which you hope to land as softly as possible, to be able to absorb the impact properly, or not to have that pain in your knees again when you land. When we are jumping, of course, we have to focus on the technique of the trick we want to do, but on the landings too. Landings are the most critical moments for our knees because they have to absorb the high loads caused by the impact on the water. And with lack of power in your legs or a sore knee, sucks, right? So let's have a closer look to understand what happens in our legs and knees during landings.
Here you see the influences of landing forces on the knee joint. Both the vertical and posterior ground reaction forces have the tendency to produce knee flexion during landing. This imposed knee flexion must be countered by several leg muscles, like the quadriceps, to prevent collapse of the lower extremity during landings.
It's important to note that large landing forces, excessive quadriceps activity, and an upright posture during landing are injury risk factors, for example, for anterior cruciate ligament torn and other injuries. And just by the way, in unhooked mode, the strain is much more than in hooked mode, unfortunately. In summary, to master landing mechanics, you have to have big brakes, meaning strong muscles throughout your lower extremities, as well as great core stability. And now guys, let's be honest. Have you ever trained your legs for kitesurfing? Tell me in the comments what you've experienced with your knees and landings. And so to help you out, I'm gonna show you some exercises you can do to get better performing knees. The videos are indicating how many reps, time, per set you should do. Okay, so let's go.
For these exercises, you will need a resistant band and a sling trainer. Okay, first we're gonna start with lunge with a twist. Fix your resistant band at the height of your chest with your doorknob or somewhere else. Now step forward with one foot into a basic lunge position. As you bend your knee, be sure to keep it in line with your foot. Try to stabilize your knee to avoid any twist. Straight out your arms by holding in front of you your resistant band at chest level. From your midsection, twist your upper body to the side of your front leg as far as possible. Keep your core engaged and squeeze your glutes. In a slow and controlled movement, return to your starting position. Stay in the lunge position and repeat the rotation for the whole set. After you have finished one side, you switch to the other side. Performing the lunge while holding and rotating, engage the quads, glutes and core, and it improves your knee control, balance and your proprioception. Okay, second exercise, lunge with a sling trainer. Okay, for this exercise you will need your sling trainer. Adjust the straps of your sling trainer to mid-calf. Stand a big step in front of the anchor point, facing away. Now place one foot in the cradle. Drive the suspended leg back and lower your front leg into a lunge with the knee at 90 degrees. Keep chest lifted and hold tension in your arms and move them with. Now return to your starting position and repeat. After finishing the reps, swap the legs. Keep a good control of your knees in line with your foot and don't move them to the side. This exercise builds your leg strength and a very good knee control. Okay, let's go over to the third exercise, squat jumps. Hold the sling trainer handles with straight arms and lean back with your feet hip-width apart. Now lower into a squat, then squeeze your glutes and drive up powerfully and jump. Control your landings and try to land as softly and smoothly as possible and then repeat in a continuous action. This increases your leg strength as well as your explosive power and deceleration of load. Okay, let's lay down for the next exercise, hamstring curls. Lay on your back with your heels in the foot cradles of your sling trainer. Legs are extended and the straps are set about 1 or 2 feet above the ground. Engage your glutes, lower back and your hamstrings to raise the hips and lower back off the floor. Maintain this raised position and proceed to pull your heels towards your buttocks. The shoulder blades remain in contact with the floor and your arms are outwarded by your side pressing into the floor to help stabilize your torso. As you are lifting your hips, squeeze your glutes and pull in your abdominals to avoid overusing the lower back muscles. Keep your hips raised as you return to your starting position by extending your legs back out. And the last exercise, hamstring runner. Go into the same starting position as in the exercise before. Instead of pulling both legs to your buttocks, pull only one leg, contracting the hamstrings, and keep the other leg extended. At the same time as you return the leg to the starting position, bring the next leg in towards the body. Strong hamstrings improve your leg strength and knee stability, and it also lowers back relief.
Please don't forget to make sure to warm up properly before you work out, as these exercises need a good preparation. And of course, there are tons more exercises and variations, but for the beginning, it's good to build a basis with few exercises so that the execution of the movements are correct. In a later video, I'll dive with you into this and how you can increase the intensity. The basis to be able to perform these exercises safely is on the one hand the right execution of the landing technique and that you have previously built up a good basic strength in the legs. Therefore, these exercises are aimed at kitesurfers who already have a good landing technique and are already making jumps and now want to improve their landing. If you're in the phase of learning jumps or are unsure about the right landing technique, I will go into that in part 3 of this series. And if you've got some serious pain, please get checked by a doctor before you try these exercises. In some cases, it's advisable to design and adapt the exercises individually. Okay guys, that's it for today. Thank you for watching and thumb up if you like this video. And don't forget to follow my channel so you don't miss my tips to improve your kitesurfing. See you in my next video and happy flying!